when you wrote Anjaam, was that an obsession that, I mean, was it, when you wrote Anjaam, did you keep Madhuri in mind?
Oh, yes. There is no question about it. Like, Bekhudi was definitely for Kajol. And Anjaam was for Madhuri. Because I'd done Bekhudi with Kajol and I said, look, you know, everybody in the industry thinks that I've got two daughters. One is Madhuri and the other one is Kajol. So since I've already done a film for the younger one, I thought I should do something for the older one as well. Besides, I did think that the role in Anjaam was a very wide one. It's a very happy-go-lucky, a very self-contained, very Madhuri in real life kind of character who's suddenly thrown in contact with an obsessive man like Shah Rukh in the film. And how she reacts to it, how she tries to protect her family, herself. And then when she actually falls prey to his machinations, and then the kind of self-respect that she's lost, and the kind of anger that dwells within her, and how slowly, how volcanic she becomes until she destroys all the people who destroyed her family. I thought the range of emotions was there, and I think Madhuri's gave a wonderful, wonderful performance, and she was so immersed in it.
And talking about M.F. Hussain's Gaj Gaon,
you know, Hussain Saab, I asked him, I said, you know, what is it that you find in Madhuri? And this was on the sets of Dil To Pagal Hai. I was doing the commercial stills, and Hussain Saab was sitting right next to me. And Madhuri was getting ready in the corner, and she was having a cup of tea, and she was talking to the makeup artist, and she was talking to an assistant director. I think Adi was also there. This was in the famous studio in Mahalakshmi. And she said, just look at her. Look at the way she holds a cup. Look at the way her fingers are so delicately poised. Now look at the way she'll put her cup down. She's completely unaware. There's no camera. Nobody's looking at her. But she has this inherent grace. She is such an Indian woman. Her, the way she talks, the way she smiles, it's grace and beauty and a certain Indian quality that's oozing out of her. And he said she's really the embodiment or the ultimate epitome of what you would call as Indian feminism.